So I will just explain you the whole process once again. Okay. So in case taking and analysis. So what you do? You see, first is the overview, or you can say the first 10 minutes. This is the first step of case taking. In this you can get an idea about what are the things. You can get an idea of what is the problem, where is the problem, who has the problem, since when is the problem, why is the problem, what modifies the problem. So you can get an idea about what is the pace of the problem, what is the depth of the problem. This is what you are going to get in the first 10 minutes. What is the level of the problem? What is the origin, duration and progress of the problem? How did it start? How did it progress? So this is the first most important step of the case taking. In this 10 minutes, you are going to get an idea of where to go, what to ask, what to expect, what kind of remedy are you looking for, what level it is, where you are going to get the clarity. You are going to get an idea about that. And once you get an idea about that, then you can start your process or understand. And then the next step is that you can understand, first of all, what is the chief complaint with its exactness, what happens exact, and what is the exact means, what is the location, sensation, modality, concomitant, and then what is the effect of this on the person. Also, what is the exciting factor? So this is the chief complaint. One, associated complaint. 1, 2, 3, 4, whatever it may be. And in all of that, exactness, exact, 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 subtle, like that. Then comes completeness. That means you got to, suppose the patient has given physical, so you got to complete it by the mental, the general, and in the mental you can have the nature, the emotions, the psychosomatic manifestations, the delusions, the dreams, and then the fears, and then childhood, interests and hobbies, relationship, occupation, etc. A very important part of this is observation. And a very important part of this is peripheral vision. That means one thing leading to the other. For example, he may talk about, suppose he's talking about, let's say, his cravings. Maybe, doctor, you know, I like this so very much, but I am to be very careful. If I eat this and that, then I can get problem, like this patient said. So more important than the craving becomes his cautiousness, or what it means. So in this way, peripheral vision, every stage of the case, you are going to get symptoms of the mind if you look carefully enough. Then, of course, the observation of his attendants, relatives, friends, etc. So in this way, you have to complete the whole information. Once you have the overview, the exactness and the completeness, then you go to the next step, which is the analysis. Analysis means that you divide it into the boxes. Roughly, I would think 8 boxes are good. So, in this box, you have the pathology. And then in this box, you have the local symptoms. 1, local symptoms, 2 associated. Then comes the emotions and nature. Then comes the delusions and dreams. Then comes the sensation. Then comes the miasm. Then comes the genius. So in this way, you can understand little bit. This is the analysis. So you put everything in the right frame or the right box. The clearest, wherever it is clearest, that becomes the anchor. So the miasm may be the anchor. For example, in this case, the miasm is the anchor. That is the clearest you can see. Because the pattern, so another word for this is pattern identification or pattern match, where the pattern clearly matches. As far as the local symptoms are concerned, or emotions or dreams are concerned, even sensation, all of them are patterns. You cannot take from one word, but there should be a whole pattern. This pattern can also be called in local symptoms, it is called fingerprinting. So you have a clear pattern. So usually when you put it in boxes, each box will become like a fingerprint. So you may have a very clear fingerprint. If you have a clear fingerprint, you can start with that. If you have a clear miasm, you start with that. Then you start to see what is the next most clearest. That is your evaluation. This is the clearest, what is the next most? Maybe in this case, it was the delusion level that was the clearest. So from here, keeping this as the anchor, you look at this, and then when you look at the delusion level, then whatever remedies are coming here, look at that in the context of this one. Right? So which out of these fit this miasm? So by that time you will get a rough idea which remedies you are looking at. Then you can look at fingerprint 1, 2, pathology, emotions, genius, sensation, whatever it may be. The main, the most prominent, the most, here comes the most individual and the peculiar. Here is where the individual and peculiar come. What is the most peculiar here? What is the most peculiar? Another important thing we left out is the word depth. That means each symptom has to be examined to the deepest possible level. So if the patient has fear of alone and dark at night, if he has got fear, what is the fear? So that fear has to be examined. Then you come to the delusion in this case that there is somebody standing near him or in the room. Then you ask, what is that person going to do? Then he says, he may attack me, maybe, but that's not important because it's not clear. What is the experience? It's not clear. So the deepest level you can reach in this case is the delusion that somebody is in the room besides him. So you have to understand each one to its depth. If you push that further, you will go into unclarity to the focal point where it is clearest. In this way, you have to take the main one from here, the main from here, the main, and then what is also important, another word that is important, is you can say the connecting thread. So when you go into the depth of something, so you will be able to see that that depth over here connects to the depth here, connects to the depth here, because ultimately at a deeper level, everything is just one thing. So definitely his vitiligo, his fear, his panic attacks, his nature, everything will be seen as one or as different aspects of the same remedy. And when that happens, when you see the connecting thread, either in terms of sensation, miasm, remedy, you can see a connection. Yesterday we saw one case where this, you know, this kind of what he called compression, and the other side was open. This was connecting everywhere in his arthritis, also immobility. What is immobility? It is like this. What is the experience of scuba diving? It is like that. So you are able to see everywhere connection. Or you can see that the symptom, for example, he had pinching pain that comes suddenly and decreases slowly in cactus. So the remedy connects. So this is known as synthesis, bringing everything together, synthesis. Using one in order to understand the other, this is called synergy, where you are able to see symptom, system, and genius coming together. That is called synergy. So this is the whole process of, and finally, last word is confirmation. So once you have, after all this process, understood the remedy, you confirm it by certain confirmatory symptoms, which are often mandatory in all cases of that remedy, because they are very, very core or essence symptoms. For example, if a case is of, let us say, it is of calcarea carbonica, so the feeling of insecurity, the sweating, the craving for eggs, these are usually confirmatory. The aggravation from slight exertion, ascending, fear of high places, cannot tolerate tight clothes. I have given all these confirmatory symptoms in Soul of Remedies. What you find in most of the cases of that remedy. This is the whole process.